Next, what we're going to do in MATLAB is try to plot more than one bit of data at a time. So say we have some t going from, I don't know, I'm going to namespace it from 0 to 10 with, I don't know, 25 elements. And then I want to graph the, I don't know, whatever, f of x. We'll make that the log of t. So remember, this is log base 10 by nature, I think. No, this isn't log base 10. This is natural log by nature. Let me check it out. Natural log. This is actually the natural log. There we go. So let's go ahead and I'm going to plot t f x y. And there's my log function. You're like, yay, that looks like a log function. That's amazing. Okay, log function. Okay, but now on top of my log function, for no particular reason, I want to plot a sine function. So g is going to be the sine of t, and doesn't really matter whether it's in degrees or radians, because whatever. And so then I want to plot t and g, and you're like, wait, where'd my first plot go? My first plot's gone, this is stupid. Okay, so I'm going to pause it and see what happens. Pause. So it's waiting for me to hit enter, and I hit enter, and then it goes away. So if I pause it for like 3 seconds, it'll show the first one for 3 seconds, and then it'll show the next one. You're like, well, that's not exactly what I wanted. Okay, so this is actually really neat. One of the things you can do, well, there's actually a couple ways to do it. One way I could do it is instead of plotting t and f, and then plotting the second one later, I could plot t of f and f, and then I could plot t and g together. And what that's going to do is MATLAB's going to plot the first one, and then it's going to plot the second one. Now, here's the thing. You can probably tell that this sine function doesn't look very good. And if I reduce the number of points in my lens space, it's actually going to look worse. So this is something that's really important. If you get something that tells you to plot a sine function, don't turn this in. It's like, look, I got a sine function. It kind of looks like a sine function, even if it's a little wonky. Technically, that's still the sine function, but you're smart enough to know that's not a sine function. So you want to make sure that you have enough points so that those sine functions and things like that, so that they look really pretty and they look smooth and they look elegant, because you're plotting and you're wasting all this time. Not wasting all this time, you're spending all this time learning, and you at least want what you produce to be pretty. So this is definitely one way you could do it. I think some part of me thinks that you could say plot t and then f and g, since they both have the same t. No, never mind. I know there's some other way you could do this. So this is one way definitely to do it. Another way that you could do it is you could say plot t and f, and then you can tell MATLAB, hold on, and then I want you to plot t and g. And so notice what this did is actually plotted them both in the same color, because what MATLAB does by default is it plots everything in blue, and since it was plotting everything kind of from scratch, it's going to automatically plot it in blue. The main reason that I like using the hold on is that allows me to be really specific, and I can say, well, I want this one in red with diamonds, and I want it to be dashed, and I can say, well, I want this to be magenta, but no marker, and I want it to have a dot dash line, I guess. I don't know, I'm just making this up. So, That's really obnoxious. It's called a dash dot. That's why that's happening. So I'm going to close this. And notice that it didn't actually update. That's because I had hold on. So now if I'm going to redo this, and I actually say, instead of being a diamond, I want it to be an X, what it's going to do is it put X's on top of the diamonds. And that's because the hold on was still there. I think I can actually tell it to hold off. And no, it's not going to work. So what I want to do, really what I have to do, is I have to close figure one. Can I do it that way? No, I don't think I can. No, a specified window does not exist. Okay, I'm trying to remember exactly how I want to do that. I think I can just close. Oh, there we go, close figure one. And then whenever I run it again, oh, I just closed it while I was running it. So probably what I want to do is, instead of plot it and then close it, I want to close it and then plot it, because that would make more sense. Oh, except now it's not open. So you know what? I'm just going to have to close it all by myself, like a big girl. Put on my big girl pants and close my figure. So now you can see there's the X's. So since it's got hold on, if I go in here and again, if I change that X over to diamond and I plot it again, since it didn't close the figure and it's still held, it's just going to put things on top. So one of the best things you can do while you're, I don't know what it's called, troubleshooting, is to close things, close figures in between whenever you run things so that you know for sure what you're getting. So this is kind of a cool way that you can plot data more or less at the same time. Something else that you can do that's pretty neat with plotting more than one bit of data at a time. So I showed you how you could do this, and this is all well and good. You can actually add a legend where you say the first one is like meat and the second one is potatoes. And if you do that and you plot it, it will actually tell you whatever you plotted first would be meat, and the second thing that you plotted is potatoes. So instead of calling them meat and potatoes, I could call them what they actually are, which is a log, natural log. And the second one is a sine function, sine of x. So natural log of x and sine of x. And then whenever I plot it, the legend will actually tell me where that is. And MATLAB by default is going to try to put the legend in a decent place, but it doesn't always guess that right. And there are ways that you can go in and control it if you really, really care. But in general, you know, you just kind of let it do its thing, and it usually does a pretty good job.